e-learning UG course in drawing and painting, drawing and painting department, faculty of arts, Dyalbagh Educational Institute. Course number BDP 101, Lesson 4. Welcome. Let's start with the today's class, which is value. After going through this lesson, you will be able to understand the meaning of value and its importance in art. How light and shadow plays its role in value. A study of basic forms through value. Methods of creating value in objects. Introduction. The purpose of this class is to learn value and their uses in a work of art. Value refers to the use of light and dark in a drawing. The changes in tones from black to white are one of the main causes of determining the three-dimensional nature in forms. We recognize roundness in the modulated shadows, the gradual shifts from dark to light on the surface of the cylindrical or sphere, flatness in the distinctly shades, planes, and sharp value contrast on the pyramid or cube. It is quite possible to render accurate drawing of a three-dimensional object using only shadow and light without the use of line. However, it is generally helpful in the beginning to seek out simple value patterns to help structure and organize more complex forms. Form without line. Now see, we will learn it through exercise. Place an apple. Give a spotlight on it from one side. Then draw an apple carefully, indicating all the gradations of light and shadow on it. Again, place a multi-sided form with four or more surfaces. Then draw the form showing the varied qualities of light that falls on each side of the form. Note how this light changes slowly as it moves across the surface of each plane. Through this exercise, you can learn the structure of value and can be applied in hundreds of different situations. Light and shadow. As you become more familiar with the shadow, you will recognize the role of value with an individual shadow in shapes. Beside the basic flow of dark and light, there are three other distinctions that you should be aware. First, highlight. Second is reflected light, and third, cast shadow. The highlight. Highlight appears as a line or area of very bright light on the surface of a form. In drawing, This highlight may be emphasized by erasing it. Highlight often suggests the most forward-moving part of the object. Reflected light. Reflected light appears on the edge of a shadowed form because of the reflection of light area that comes directly from the source and generally appears when a shadow is placed next to another dark surface. The use of reflected light helps to convey a sense of three dimension and sets the form off from other dark areas around it. Cast shadow. The cast shadow do not define the surface of a form. They are the dark shadow cast upon a surface by an object that stands between the surface and the light source. Let's start with the next topic, texture. Now we will start our fifth lesson, in which we will learn about texture. The concept and observation of the fifth primary element, texture, really cannot be separated from the other elements, line, form, value, and space. Objectives. The meaning of texture and its importance in art. Characteristics of textures. A study of basic forms with texture. The classification of texture. Method of knowing texture. Introduction. We are conscious not only of form, space, color, dark and light tones, but also of tactile qualities, a sense of feel surface, of roughness and smoothness, hardness and softness. For instance, smoothness may suggest refinement, luxury. Roughness tends to evoke vigor, hardiness, crudity, and careless finish. What is texture? In the visual arts, texture means the surface, appearances, or character of object, which is due to their physical appearances. Every object has a textural quality, and that textural quality show object's character and effects. Artists show that quality with visual effects. When we see and touch the object, then we will get the experience of texture. It can be hard or soft, thick, rough or smooth. These hard, thick and rough texture have a different effects of light and shade. And smooth and soft texture has a different effects. These qualities depend on object. Material like it can be wool, plastic, wood or a ceramic or any other object. This differentiation of material give different textural effects on your object. The knowledge of texture can be obtained through the following two ways. One is tactile and the other one is visual. Tactile texture. Tactile texture is the actual 3D feel of a texture. Tactile means touch. When we feel hardness and softness of object by the touch, that tactile texture. Visual texture. When we feel hardness and softness of object to just see them in drawing, that we'll call visual texture or 2D texture. Here we gave only illusion of the texture. Classification of texture. There are two types of texture, found and given and artificial. Found and given. In this, all textural surfaces comes which created by man and nature, like wood, stone and bottle texture. Artificial texture. When we covered a textural surface with other texture, that we call artificial texture. It can be of two types: copied texture, imaginative and creative. Copied texture. In this, when we draw a texture with the basis of model, that called copied texture. Like when we draw a still life in which we have steel glass, glass bottle and a wooden board. In this, the original texture of paper or canvas will be covered. The texture of still life drawing will become more important. Imaginative and creative texture. With the use of different art material and medium, we can change the textural quality. The use of mixing water and oil colors, patches of thick color and any other textural medium can create a new and imaginary textural surfaces. Here I am going to show you how we can achieve different type of textures with the help of different materials. The first type of texture is obtained by using fevicol and colors. For that, first of all, we put fevicol on the surface. Allow it to dry for some time. Now we can create different types of texture using different things, like using back tip of brush and by using comb. After that, we can apply desirable colors on it. You can use either poster colors or inks, wax and watercolors. In this type of texture, watercolors are put on the waxed surface. In this method, surface can be waxed in different types of texture. Marbling. By using this technique, we can create beautiful textures. For this, we will require a big bowl containing water and enamel colors. Now, with the help of brush, we will put some drops of colors in that bowl. You will find those drops of colors floating on the surface of water. Now, with the help of the brush, we will try to spread the colors all through the surface of water. Finally, we will drop a sheet in the bowl and take it out immediately. We will drop a sheet in the bowl and take it out immediately. Now see how beautiful it is. The next topic is color, which is the most expressive element of painting. Its potential as a drawing tool extends the artist's creative possibilities in all directions, defining forms, establishing value, texture and space, stimulating the sense and emotions, unifying compositions. Objectives: the meaning of color, the kinds of color, the nature of color, the quality of color. Introduction: technically, color is composed of waves or impulses of light. If you have seen rainbow and daylight through a prism, you absorb a spectrum of color of hues: violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. Each color is created by an impulses of defining length. Violet is the shortest, red is the longest. Of these hues, red, yellow, and blue are designated as primary colors. Primary colors are basically pure hues and cannot be obtained by mixing together any other hues. Green, orange, and violet, created by a mixture of these primary colors, are called secondary colors, like orange by combining red and yellow, green from yellow and blue, and violet from red and blue. The intermediate steps between the six basic hues are called tertiary colors. Like between blue and green is called blue green. Between red and orange are called orange. In this combination, the first is primary color, then the secondary hue. If the convention is reversed, as in orange red, the implication is that the hue contains good deal more than orange, good deal more orange than red. Natural colors. For a surface as one color or another, it must reflect some color waves and absorb others. The exception of this rule is white, which reflects and absorbs virtually none, and black, which absorbs all colors and reflects none. This black and white color called natural colors. Pigments used in drawing or painting are materials of either dry, semi-dry, or liquid consistency, which contain chemicals to absorb and reflect specific qualities of light. A pigment's closeness to pure colors is referred to as its saturation level. Tertiary hues are colors dulled away from saturation by the introduction of complementary colors. Colors have three qualities: hues, values, and intensity. Hue: the nature of color is hue, means red color has nature of reddishness, Yellow color has yellowish nature. And blue color has bluish nature. Value. We can call it the darkness and the lightness of color, like light red or dark red. When we add white color in red, that decreases the value of red. And if we add black color in the red, then the value of red will be increased. So, addition of white and black can change the value of color. Intensity. That indicates the purity of color. The purity of color decreases and increases the intensity. Can also give shineness and dullness of color. When we add any other color into red, the intensity of red will be decreased. And when we put pure red color, the intensity of red will be increased. Individual hues have relative weights and sensual values as well as special characteristics. We call them warm and cool colors. The hues on the opposite side of the wheel, green, blue, violet, and the intermediate tertiaries are termed cool. Blue and green, considered cool colors, appear to reside and rise when used in relation to other colors. The hues on the other side of the color wheel, yellow, orange, red, and their tertiaries are called warm colors. Yellow and red are warm colors, which comes forward, appear heavy, and give the impression of heat. Complementary hues. Hues situated opposite one another on the color wheel are termed complementary hues. Yellow and violet are complementary, as are red and green, blue and orange. Complementary hues plays two roles. They can either nullify or intensify each other. When mixed together, complementary hues neutralize each other. On the other hand, surrounding a spot of intense green with intense red cause both colors to be reinforced. Now we talk about color schemes. Color schemes for achieving satisfying relationship of color in a work of art. The three most recognized color schemes are monochromatic, analogous, and complementary color schemes. Monochromatic. Monochromatic color schemes are one that employs various values and intensity of a single hue. Analogous. Analogous color schemes employs a limited range of neighboring hues using a variety of values and intensities. Complementary color scheme. Complementary color scheme, on the other hand, combines contrasting hues such as blue and orange. These effects may be due to the color's wavelength or to our associations. Blue with the cool receding sky, yellow with the sun, and red with the fire. These are the usual reaction and association to colors. They are not rules for color usage. Artists learn through study and experience to manipulate colors to convey meaning and mood to the viewer. Many of these effects may go against the above mentioned principles and still creates an effective, even natural image. Assignments. Do a drawing of basic forms and create a value effect on this without using line. Next, do a drawing of an object with highlight, reflected light, and cast shadow. Take an object and make its textural drawing. You can choose found and given textural object. Create a textural drawing with new experiments and with your own imagination. Make a color wheel of primary and secondary colors and natural colors. Dilute your color by adding water to lessen their brightness. Apply them to make a series of circular shapes using each of the primary colors next to each other on the page. Create a wheel to show quality of colors like hue, value, and intensity. Make a drawing in which you can show effects of colors like blue in sky, yellow in sun. Take primary color wheel and add white and adding black color. Summing up. Simple value patterns can help this structure and organize more complex forms. Value refers to the use of light and dark in the drawing. The concept and observation of the fifth primary element, texture, really cannot be separated from the other element, line, form, value, and space. By that, you can explore your imagination and expression clearly. A multitude of purpose in any given drawing. Establishing value patterns, locating objects in the space, describing surface, structuring compositions. Color is a most expressive element of painting by which we can extend the artist's creativity possibilities in all directions. Terminal questions. Do a drawing with value and how you will create it with the help of light and shadow. What do you understand by highlight, reflected light, and cast shadow? What do you understand by texture? Define the textural qualities of found and given textural object. How you will create a new imaginary drawing with texture. Create a color wheel showing primary, secondary, and tertiary colors and define the quality of color. Thank you and hope you will enjoy the lesson.